Hello, welcome back. According to many requests through the website and the channel, we will talk in this video about the difference between IGCSE and O level. I cannot express to you how incredibly important this to you as a student, because it's very important to understand your exam board that you're gonna pass through. Well, we will talk about the grading system and the exam papers and the contents as a difference or a comparison between IGCSE and O level. Please stay in. As you see in this diagram, we have two main sections for today's video, like IGCSE, O levels. In IGCSE, we have two branches, like core, extended. In core, you should pass through three papers. The first paper is paper one and paper three. Both these two papers consider core. Then you need to go through paper five or paper six. Remember, in paper one, three, five, or six, you're gonna get a certificate from the kind which is core. And actually, the maximum grades that you could award here is just from C up to G. C is the maximum grade, G is the minimum grade. But when it comes to extended, and this is the majority of the students, they could pass through the extended paper if you go through IGCSE. You need to pass through again three different papers, paper two, paper four, paper five, or paper six. And through this exam board, you could get a grade system from A star up to C. That was IGCSE. But when it comes to O level, we still have three papers also. They have almost the same name, like paper one, paper two, paper three, or four. Paper 1 and paper 2, this is the O level. Paper 3 or paper 4, this is related to practicum. Now let's take another deeper idea. When it comes to IGCSE, as you see in this screen, paper 2 and paper 4, they are extended. But when it comes to paper 5 or paper 6, this is related to practical. Like I could say paper 5, this is a real practical test, but paper 6, this is alternative to practical. Actually, there is no real practical in paper 6. It's just an experiment done before and you need to write some comments about it. But let's go back again to paper 2. Paper 2 in IGCSE, it's a multiple choices and actually it's related to extended. When it comes to paper two, the time allowed to pass through this paper, it's 45 minutes from the beginning of the exam. And actually it's the total mark is 40 marks. This is what you need to know. For paper four, the time will be a little longer because it's theory questions. The time is 1 hour and 15 minutes. It's around 75 minutes and the total mark is 80 marks. Remember, in average, the time allowed for any exam paper, it's equivalent to like 1 minute means 1 mark, or 1 mark means 1 minute. When it comes to paper five or paper six, the time allowed is only 1 hour in case of paper six, 1 hour, 15 minutes in case of paper five, because we have a real practical in paper five, but it's not real practical in paper six. It's just alternative to practical. And the marks allowed for both is 40 marks. Now let's take a deeper idea also. For O level is just paper one and paper two. Paper one, multiple choice. It's exactly like paper two in case of extended, or paper one in case of core when it comes to IGCSE. And the time allowed is a little longer, like 15 minutes extra when it comes to O level. So it's 1 hour for 40 marks. Paper two, it's 1 hour, 45 minutes. And it's much longer, like it's 105 minutes for 80 marks, because the questions in O level will be a little deeper and it depends on the language. And this is, to be honest, this is for the natives, if your mother tongue is English. And it's usually carried out inside UK. And still the marks, like 40 marks and 80 marks for paper two. and 40 marks for paper one. When it comes to paper three and four, this is practical test paper three, alternative to practical when it comes to paper four. The time for the real practical is 1 hour 30 minutes, and it's also longer in O level comparing by IGCSE by around 15 minutes. And paper four, it still have 1 hour, exactly like paper six in IGCSE. That was for the exam papers. Now let's back to IGCSE for the exam papers for IGCSE. As you see here, in paper two, as we said, it's 45 minutes, 40 marks. The load of the paper, this is very important. The load of the paper is 30%. For paper four, the load is 50%. For the practical assessment, I mean paper five or paper six, is just 20%. All papers are very important, but when it comes to the load of the paper, it gives you an idea how important is it. Like if I lose one mark in paper six and I lose another mark in paper four, the mark which I lose in paper four will affect my overall more than the mark that I lose in paper six, because the load in paper four is much higher than the load in paper six, as you see. Let's go to a little calculations down, because if you calculate the total numbers of all papers, you will got 160 marks in total. Like, let's count them together. Paper two, it's 40 marks. Paper four is 80 marks. And paper five or paper six, both of them 40 marks. So 40 plus 40 plus 80, the total is 160. But when you get your certificate, your marks could be out of 200. So this 160 could be changed to 200. Here is a little calculation in the down of the page. Like for paper two, because the load is 30%, so this 40 marks will be changed to 60 marks, because when it comes to 30% out of 200, it's supposed to be 60. And 50% for paper four, it could be changed, the mark of paper four, from 80 to be 100, because 80, this is out of 160, 50%, and 100, this is out of 200, this is still 50%, and this is the meaning of the load of the paper. For paper six, it could be stays as it is, like 40% out of 200, it means it's just 20%. So when I say 40 marks, it means 20% out of 200. So 40 out of 200, this is for paper six. And once when I add all your marks or new marks, will be changed into a number out of 200 instead of 160. The same idea here when it comes to O level, as you see in the screen. In multiple choices, we have 30% for paper one, and we have 50% for paper two, and we have still 20% for paper six. So in this idea, paper four or paper three, when it comes to the difference in this point, actually there is no difference in the load of the paper. Like, we still have the same percentage, 30, 50, 20. So all these marks will be changed to be out of 200 instead of 160 by the same way. Here is a little calculation. Like, when it comes to paper two, for example, and paper four, and here we have paper six. As we said, paper two, it could be a mark X divided by the total mark in paper two is 40. And paper four, your mark will be X4, let's do it like that, divided by 80. And for paper six, your mark is X6 divided by the total marks here in paper six will be 40. So the total in this case, if you add them, as you see here, it could be your mark, which is X2 plus X4 plus X6 divided by the total mark here, which is 160. This is what you could see. But in our new calculations, paper two will be changed to be out of 60, and paper four will be changed to be out of 80, and paper six will be changed or stays as it is like out of 40. So paper four here. So as you see, paper two will be changed to be out of 60, and paper four will be changed to be out of 100, and paper six will be changed to be out of 40. And as you see, the total here will be changed to be out of 200. This is the meaning of the load. So paper 2, it has a load which is 30%, and paper 4, it has a load which is 50%, and paper 6, it has a load which is just 20%. Another calculation, depending on real numbers, like if you got in paper 2, let's say an example, your mark in paper 2 was like 33 out of 40, and in paper 4, you got, for example, 68 out of 80, and in paper 6, for example, you got out of 40, you got, for example, 32 out of 40. And now we could do a little calculations using the calculator. I'm gonna change each paper to its load. Like, as you see here in the calculator, it could be 33 divided by 40. Then the result should be times the new mark for paper 2 is 60. So I'm going to say times 60. It means your new paper 2 will be changed to 49.5 out of 60. But when it comes to paper 4, so I'm going to say that 69 or 68 divided by 80, then times 100. So your mark here will be changed to be 85 out of 100. Then when it comes to paper 6, this is the easy one. It could be stays as it is, 32 out of 40. Now when we add all these marks, you will get a mark out of 200. So your new mark right now will be changed to be 49.5 plus 85 plus 32 divided by 200. If you said times 100, this is will give you the grades in percentage form. Depending on that, you can calculate your grades. Is it A star or A or B or whatever? Thank you for watching. You can see many solve it past papers through this link. Thank you. See you next class. Bye.